In a previous video, you saw how to use Data Migration Assistant to assess your on-prem data estate. In this video, you'll see some new capabilities around using the command line tools and Azure Migrate to assess multiple instances and more, this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Rajesh Setlem, a program manager on the Azure SQL team. Thanks for being with us today.
Thanks, Anna. Thanks for having me.
And, you know, before, actually almost a year ago, Raj and I got on the show and we talked about Data Migration Assistant. And we did all of this using a GUI, but now there are new capabilities. Is that kind of what's going on?
Yeah, that's right, Anna. It's been a year since we since the last video was published. This was about running Data Migration Assistant through the UI, integrating those capabilities into Azure Migrate. And then there's been a lot of requests from customers where they wanted to do it through command line arguments. And that's what we want to talk about in this video.
Awesome. Cool. Yeah, I know a lot of customers feel more comfortable with command line, and maybe they feel like they can do more with command line. So I'd love to just get right into it and see what it can do.
Exactly. Okay. So let me go ahead and start sharing my screen and then show you the capabilities in action. Sure. Thanks, Anna. As you can see, I just want to give a quick introduction of the tool that we're talking about. This is Data Migration Assistant, also referred to as DMA. It's a popular tool that customers use when they want to migrate to Azure. They want to assess their on-premise instance, see if it is ready for a target Azure SQL instance, and then identify if there are any migration issues, migration blockers, any behavioral changes, any breaking changes, and go from there. And here's the link that I was talking about, where in the past, what we had done is we had created released this capability where you can assess the data estate using Data Migration Assistant using a GUI, and then upload the results to Azure Migrate. As you can see, a couple of prerequisite steps that you have to do here is you create a project, you add the Data Migration Assistant as a tool, and then you assess the SQL Server instance, and then upload the results back into Azure Migrate. So once you create the assessment, you would have an option to say upload to Azure Migrate, the box right here, and then you would start seeing the assessment results in the Azure portal. So what we're going to do today now is do all of these capabilities using GUI, because as we can anticipate, if someone wants to assess a data estate, you wouldn't have a couple of handful instances. You would have tens of SQL Server instances or even more than that. And the goal here is to how do you automate all of that into a command line and then scale to your data estate needs. So Data Migration Assistant comes with a command line tool called DMACMD.exe. And we are going to look at the parameters that are exposed by DMACMD.exe and how do we leverage those capabilities. So if I go into my DMA install, I have this a command line interface called DMACMD.exe. I can do a quick help on it. It'll give you the parameters and the actions that are supported by it. As you can see, it's a pretty rich tool. All the capabilities that you can do from the UI can very well be done using the command line options. So for the purpose of today's call, what we'll do is, let me go into a folder that I created for the demo, and then I'll show you how do you run this command using the CLI command. So what I'm trying to do here is, I'm using the DMACMD.exe. I'm passing in an argument called assess, and then I'm passing in an assessment configuration file. So essentially, all the things that you would have done in the UI is actually bundled up into the XML file. So let's take a quick look at what the XML looks like. And then I also want to call out that we will get this published into a doc link and then have that linked up into the video so that you don't have to manually type any of this. You can just copy the sample from the doc page. So as you can see, you start with an assessment name. That's what I want to do, give a name to the assessment. I want to assess my source platform, which is SQL on-prem. In the target platform, in this case, for the purpose of this demo, I want to showcase, let's say, I want to assess for managed SQL Server, which is managed SQL instance. Had it been SQL DB, you would say Azure SQL Database, and we would have all of that information in the doc page on what are the target platform which is supported. And then here are a couple of examples where I'm showing, in this case, I have two instances, a SQL 2016 instance and then a SQL 2017. What I really quickly want to show is, in the first instance, I want to assess all the databases in it, while on the second instance, I just want to pick and choose two databases. And this is what I have. I mean, this is my laptop, so I don't have tons of SQL Server instances, but essentially have two instances, a bunch of databases on first one. On the second one, I just want to pick and choose the two databases, right? And then once you specify the databases, then you have the option to include all the results where the command will output the results. So there are a couple of options, essentially three options. One is you can output the result into a .dma file, which is essentially you can open up in a GUI file called, you could open up in the program called DMA GUI. The other one is you can open it up in a JSON file, and then you can also save it into a CSV file, which I'll show you once we run the command. And then if you want to overwrite the result, you set that to true. And essentially, and this is all the capabilities exposed by DMA. You can do compatibility issues, or you can do feature parity issues. And then cloud environment, if you want to do public clouds, you do Azure. And the advantage with capability with upload Azure Migrate is we also support gov clouds and also sovereign clouds like China and Germany. And then you specify the subscription ID, the Azure Migrate project name, resource group name. You ask for the authentication ID, authentication pop-up to show up, and then the Azure authentication tenant ID, which is essentially an Azure Active Directory tenant ID. The way you get there is to get the authentication ID. If you go to Azure portal and then click on Azure Active Directory, you would see the tenant ID information right there in the overview page. As you can see, this is the tenant ID information that shows up. So you copy those information, and then the last important element to this XML is you want to set the enable assessment upload to Azure Migrate to true, and then you're good to go. So let's go ahead and run this command. I'll wait for the pop-up to show up.
So while this is running, Rajesh, so what we're doing is we're actually doing the assessment, but first you have to authenticate and then we can start the assessment, or why do you have to authenticate?
Yeah, so that's a good question, Anna. So the reason why we have to authenticate is, since we said we want to upload the results to Azure Migrate, we just want to make sure, are you able to authenticate into Azure at all in the first place? And then we would start the assessment of the databases. And that's the reason why we first authenticate, and then the assessment kicks off in the background where it starts going after all the instances, all the databases that you specified in the XML file.
Gotcha. Okay, that makes sense. Because in the GUI, you kind of do it step by step by step, but here you kind of get to do it all at once.
Exactly. And authentication is something that we want to capture that information right before we do the assessment, so that you get authenticated, and then once the results are ready, we upload it back to Azure Migrate. So I'm just waiting for the pop-up to show up, for the multi-factor authentication to go ahead. So while this is going on, I won't wait. This will take a couple of minutes. Since I had close to 20 odd databases in both the instances, it will take a few minutes. What I would show you is how the output would look like once the command succeeds. So once the command succeeds, what you would see is you would see the number of databases that were assessed, the number of instances that were assessed, and then also specific information around whether the upload to Azure Migrate actually completed or not. So here, as you can see, the uploading started, and then the uploading completed, and then a quick statistics of all the instances and databases that were uploaded, right? So let's go back into Azure Migrate. So if you are not familiar with Azure Migrate, so this is a one-stop solution for all your migration needs, and it supports both servers and databases and web applications as well. So what we are going to do here is, so if you navigate into Azure Migrate and then click on Assess and Databases, you would see an option to add your assessment tool, and then you would land up into this page. So once the upload completes, you would see data for those instances here. As you can see, we had assessed two instances, and that's what it shows up. Let's get into those instances and get a high-level view of what is happening to those instances, how ready are those instances to migrate to Azure SQL. As you can see, in 2016 instance, this is 90% ready. There are 20 databases, and I know for a fact there are a couple of databases which are not ready, and that's why it shows 90% ready. But for the other one, it's 100% ready. And if you also want to get into the next level of details, we also show those level of details once you double-click into it. So, as we said, We wanted to target a SQL managed instance. So this is the target in Azure where we want to assess for. And then as you can see, we have a column which says, is it ready for SQL DB or is it ready for SQL VM? As we can see, we saw that in the earlier screen that there were two databases where they were not ready for SQL managed instance. And these are the two databases where we have some migration blockers. It's not ready for managed instance, but it is completely ready for SQL VM. So you get that holistic view of what's happening at instance level, and you can do this for the entire data estate. If I can quickly go back into the other instance, everything looks good here. I want to go to the assess for target MI, and then there are no blockers. I can easily migrate it to SQL managed instance. So the next obvious question that customers would have is, once I get this view here, and this kind of helps at a head of a database group who wants to know what is the readiness state of his or her database SQL Server instances for all the application that the team supports, right? Once you have these details, you would want to get into, double-click into what are the actual migration blockers for those SQL Server databases, right? As I said, once the command runs, it outputs the data into three formats. So this is one of the format, which is a .dma file. You can open it up in DMA. As you can see in the archive database, you have a couple of migration blockers. So one is a file stream file group, which is not supported yet in MI. And then the other one, I have a table with a file stream column, and that's why it's flagging it out. And similarly for wide world importers, I manually created a migration blocker by creating an additional log file, which is not supported in MI. So as you can see, you get that richness of detailed view of what are the migration blockers at a database level, but you also get the overall readiness status of the entire data estate.
Awesome. Thanks, Rajesh. That was really cool. You know, what I really liked is how you were able to put in a bunch of servers and analyze a lot of databases and servers at one time. I don't think that's something you can easily do with the GUI today. Is that right?
Yeah. It can be done in the GUI, but that's a very painful process where you have to connect every instance, add a bunch of databases, select or deselect the databases that you want to go through. And it's not scalable once you get into tens and probably start getting into 30 or 40 or even 50 or 100 instances of SQL Server. It becomes even more difficult to do all of that in the GUI.
Yeah, definitely. And so, you know, as we kind of, you know, you've shown us a lot, and I think a lot of people are going to want to go get their hands on this. So we'll definitely put resources in the description. But if you had to give our viewers a few tips, what advice would you give?
Yeah, that's a good question, Anna. So what we definitely recommend is we don't want customers to provide all the SQL Server instances. If they have hundreds of SQL Server instances, we don't want them to provide all those instances in one assessment configuration file and then start assessing, because that wouldn't scale. Typically, what the recommendation is, scope it to an application, a bunch of SQL Server instances, maybe tens of SQL Server instances that works, and then go from there. The idea is here is to batch up those assessments into finite sets and then provide that as an input in the XML file and then start the assessments. So that's one recommendation. The other recommendation is, as you can see in the demo, what we did was we assessed for SQL managed instance, but there are also customers or scenarios where you would want your source SQL Server instance to be assessed for SQL managed instance and SQL DB as well. So you would want to know what is the readiness status for both the target platforms in Azure, right? In those cases, the recommendation is create a separate Azure Migrate project for MI and one for DB so that you don't override those results. And the last piece of advice, which is again based on performance, is when assessments run, it is CPU bound because it connects to a source instance, connects to a source database, and then tries to extract a DAC pack of the database, and then does all the validations, trying to figure out what are the features, blockers, and all sorts of things, so which is CPU bound. So essentially, the recommendation is run the scripts from a machine where there is enough number of cores. Probably 8 core is a good start, and then probably you might have to scale it up based on the number of instances or the databases that you have. So those are the basic recommendations for running assessments at scale.
Okay, so those are some good tips. So if I kind of understand correctly, your first tip is, even though I have the power now to analyze hundreds of SQL servers at once, due to many reasons, you said, let's scope it to an application. That makes it easier. And, you know, maybe even in your migration project, then you can kind of see for this application, when is it ready to go? And similarly, if you're between MI and DB, you should create different projects because otherwise they're going to overwrite themselves.
Yep, that's right.
And then the third one maybe kind of relates to the first one too, in that, you know, this does take CPU. So either you need to not assess so many, or make sure you're on a machine that can assess as many as you need.
Yep. And it is proportional to the number of database objects. So if you have a large schema, it has nothing to do with the database size. It's directly proportional to the schema size of the database. So depending on the number of schema objects, the assessment time is also proportional to that. So, and then you need to have enough CPU capacity to handle all of that.
Gotcha. Awesome. Well, thanks for joining us today, Rajesh. I personally learned a lot. I think our viewers have too. We're going to include lots of resources in the description for you to go learn more. And we'd love to hear from you to see what your experience is working with this. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.